That old early morning sun's about to break on the horizon. The coffee's a-perkin' and the bacon's a-cookin'. And it's time once again to head on up to Sportsman's Lodge and visit with Ron Jones.
We don't try to kill anything but roosters.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning, folks. How y'all doing this morning? Glad you could join me on Sportsman's Lodge. I'm Ron Jones, your host. We're on every Saturday morning at 6 a.m. right here on News 13. We certainly do appreciate you watching this program and doing business with our sponsors. That's what keeps us on air. That's what keeps us going. Be sure to tell all your friends, neighbors, church congregation about this show. And we use all the viewers we can get. We got a bunch of them now. We can always use more. But like I say, those sponsors, and I really appreciate them, all of them, for hanging in there with us and just making this such a popular show. And their support, without it, we just couldn't do it, folks. And we don't want to thank all of our sponsors very, very much. I want to say hello to Mr. Robert Moody this morning. Talked to Mr. Moody the other day, and Mr. Moody told me he's fighting that old cancer and taking them radiation treatments and things. So, but you hang in there, Mr. Moody, and our prayers and thoughts go out with you. And you just hang in there, buddy. It's, you know, it's a bad thing sometimes, but, you know, just put it in God's hands, and you know, whatever happens, happens, and that's the way it works out. And that's the way God meant for it to be. So, good morning, Mr. Robert Moody. He said he's gonna come see me one day. All right, we'll be looking for you. We look out up and down the road till we see you coming. Want to remind you now, I was up at Paul's Main Street Market, and I tell you what, folks, y'all got to get up there and get some of fresh fruits and vegetables and all that army stuff and everything. That old cheesy creamery milk they got. Pumpkins out there, and if y'all want some pumpkins, they got plenty of pumpkins up there. And Paul come up to me, he told me, he said, Ron, don't you tell them now, starting now. They got them now. He got a big old cooler up there. You can get the Apalachicola bag oysters. They don't serve them on the hash shell, but you get them in the bag. If you want them, the best thing to do is call him and tell him to hold your bag, put your name on a bag or two or three or how many you want to get, because you may get up there and they may be sold out. These things are going to go. Now, so call them at 850-638-7755. That's 850-638-7755. The number's on the screen there, and we'll have it again during the commercial. Y'all call them, tell them how many bags you want. You know what? You know about Apalachicola oysters. So tell old Paul you saw it on Sportsman's Lodge and you want to reserve you a bag or two or three or four. If it was me, I'd be reserving about five. I can put them away, I'll tell you. I love them things. Also want to remind you about Captain Helen Ghost Walk and History Tour. That's to this afternoon from 5:30 to 8:30 at Camp Helen State Park. That's just across the Phillips Inlet Bridge going toward Destin. There'll be a shuttle running from the Winn-Dixie, the west end Winn-Dixie. It'll run every few minutes from there to Camp Helen State Park. So you can't find a parking place in that Camp Helen, so you got to park in the Winn-Dixie and take the shuttle. Like I say, it's constantly running. So, and there's nothing that starts at 5:30, and you got to be there at 5:30 and ends at 8:30. This thing is, they got several tours and they're just constantly going. So y'all want to get out there. It's Camp Helen State Park, Throats Dry. And it's a ghost walking history tour starting at 5:30 this afternoon at Camp Helen State Park at Phillips Inlet. Also, want to remind you about Sunny Hills Oktoberfest. That's today. Got that shotgun drawing. I'm going to be drawing that and doing honors for them up there. Get ready to enjoy the full day of fun, festivities, and good food, and the drink, and everything else. It's Sunny Hills Oktoberfest today in Sunny Hills at the Boat Lake. It's a Boat Lake. Just turn in the entrance to Sunny Hills on Highway 77 there, where the big brick columns are and things, and the waterfall and stuff like that. It'll take you, just follow the signs to Boat Lake and Oktoberfest. On the show today, Joe Riley and Bobby Sorrells come by and pick me up today. We went out in the bay, and Joe's, boy, y'all see that boat. Y'all need to get up there and look at that boat Joe built. He kind of just built it for himself. It's designed after the other rhinos, but it's a lot bigger. And I asked him on the show, I said, can you build another one if somebody wants it? He said, absolutely. So y'all just, if nothing else, go by here and look at that. Tell him you want to see his personal boat. It's in Hartford, Alabama, Highway 52E. Joe sent me, anyway, we went out, we caught a few fish. It didn't catch a whole lot, but we had a good time, good fellowship. And the Bobby Sorrells caught a nice flounder. Joe got a nice Spanish mackerel. And I probably caught probably the most fish of all, you know. And mine was good fish, too. So, but they tried. They tried real hard, you know. And you know, that's all you can do is try. You know, when you go with me, you try. I can give you some pointers, but but you got to try. But anyway, it's going to be a good show, and we hope you enjoy it. Joe sent me this stuff a while back. I want to read you some of this stuff. It's just says questions that need to be answered. It says one of them is, can you cry underwater? Think about that. Now, can you cry underwater? And how important does a person have to be before they're considered assassinated instead of just murdered? Think about that one. Why do you have to put your 2 cents in, but it's only a penny for your thoughts? Where's that extra penny going? Somebody's getting that extra penny, and we got to find out who it is, okay? Once you're in heaven, do you get stuck wearing the clothes you were buried in for eternity? I think I can answer that one. When you enter those pearly gates, folks, the Lord's got a nice white robe waiting on you. You look around, everybody else has got a nice white robe on too. Ain't nobody better than anybody else when you get there. They're not down here either. They just, some of them got more money, some of them act like they're better than other people. But, you know, but everybody's like this. When you get in heaven, everybody's like this. And like this. They're having a good time up there. And they're all wearing them white robes anyway. Why does a pizza come in a square box when it's round? That's what I always wanted. You know, why don't they build a square pizza and give you your money's worth? Fill them corners up. You know, them corners ain't got nothing in them. Fill them corners up with that pizza. Y'all listen to this, you pizza places out there. Build that square pizza, put it in that square box, and I'll guarantee you, you publicize that, and you get the business. You get the business away from all them other people. That's what it is. What disease did cured ham actually have? Don't you think about this one. What disease did cured ham actually have? That may hit you a little while later if you didn't get it. How is it that we put a man on the moon before we figured out it would be a good idea to put wheels on luggage? That's a thought right there. Why is it that people say they slept like a baby when babies wake up every 2 hours all night long? I ain't never understood that one either. Anyway, we got some more of these. We're going to try to read. If we have some more time today, we'll do it. No, we'll read you some maybe next week. Anyway, y'all watch this, folks, and we like I said, we appreciate you watching this program and doing business with our sponsors, because that's what keeps us bringing this program to you. We have a good time with it. We have a good time presenting it to you. So y'all watch this, and we'll be right back in just a little bit, okay? All right, y'all roll that tape. Roll that tape.
It's the next best thing to the old vegetable truck. It's Main Street Market in Chipley. Owned and operated by Paul Davidson, Main Street Market stocks the largest selection of good fresh fruits and vegetables and a whole lot more.
We sell wholesale or retail.
From fresh local milk.
That's so cheesy creamery milk.
To a complete line of Amish products to livestock and pet food.
We now offer a full line of Seminole feed. We also carry a full line of frozen vegetables, all types of Amish cheese. We have Amish butter. That's one of our specialties.
Hey, you need it? We've got it. Top quality coastal Bermuda horse hay year round. If you like fresh fruits and vegetables, we have them at Main Street Market.
Corner of Highway 77 and 90 in Chipley, Florida.
Innovative Glass. Together, Mark Moody and Tim Johnson have over 2 decades of experience in the glass industry. Mark and Tim have made Innovative Glass a success story. It's a family thing. They are not brothers, but like brothers. Each one knows what the other expects. Innovative Glass has the most up-to-date equipment that you won't find at a lot of other glass companies in the area. They specialize in residential and commercial. Anything from shower doors, tabletop glass, and special made-to-fit windows and doors, Innovative Glass can handle small and large jobs, including big condo development window and door replacements. Innovative Glass has Sportsman's Lodge stamp of approval. Give them a call.
It's 850-541-2417 and 850-541-2418.
Innovative Glass, the professionals in Bay County.
Everybody's discovered Bailey's in Chipley, Florida.
I'm Bo Durham. This is my wife, April. We come from Panama City every Friday night to eat at Bailey's. The food's great.
They just can't get enough of that good Friday and Saturday night seafood buffet, stacked with big crab legs, shrimp, oysters, hot wings, and more, and then down-home cooked vegetables. Man, what you talking about? For you steak lovers, the largest selection cooked to perfection. Bailey's Surf and Turf, Highway 77 at Highway 90, Chipley, Florida. It's so good.
I've been a fisherman most of my life, and there's one thing that I know. You ain't got very much of a boat if you don't have a Rhino. No wood to rot, it'll never rust. It's a boat you can always trust. Now you know what I know.
make your boat a Rhino. You gotta have a Rhino.
Joe's Motor Service and Rhino Boats revolutionize the aluminum boat industry. Make your next boat a Rhino, and they can do service on just about any outboard.
Hard to catch that train, man. That train my baby's on. I'd have been out well, I'm headed east. I want my baby back home with me. Well, she done grabbing me no train and gone. She done bought a ticket and left this town. I'm going to find out before the sun go down. But she done grabbed that mean old train and gone. I ain't no monkey, don't climb no.
Yo, I sure like this boat.
Good, we do too.
Could you build another one just like it?
Oh, yeah.
If somebody wanted one, I'd tell you what.
We got some in stock almost like
it. Do you?
We just varied this one just a little bit because I wanted one I get room for four old men to all sit down and fish across their legs.
Well, you got two of them today. I'm going with you. Nice, bro.
She left me plenty money, gold in the ground. Ever since she left me, I've been going and down. Well, she done grabbed that mean old train and gone.
Joe, what are you doing catching Spanish? We come out here to Flounder.
That was first guess.
You're fighting that current, ain't you?
Motor wide open, 85 pounds of it in it. I barely moving.
Joe's got a Spanish on. Hope we don't get cut off. Nice Spanish. That's a legal Spanish, too.
Hey, he kept on. He bit mine, I think.
Did he?
Yeah, I just need a little help.
10 inches, he's legal. You don't think so? Shoot, the thing's good.
Well, I was going to say put him down there and try it.
Joe wanted him. We was going to measure him, but he's
going to measure him.
He was just bound and determined to put that fish back in the water. So. Little black sea bass around them rocks over there.
Well, he was little anyway.
So far, Joe's caught only two fish.
And we're going to have to do it all.
Yeah, well, you know, like I said, somebody's got to. So.
I think so.
Get us another one. Gotta keep us legal now, Bobby. Bobby got the first flounder on a new penny. I don't think I'll stick my finger down in his mouth.
He's got my new penny there.
Stick him up here and let's see if he's legal. We get it out. Gotta be 12 inches.
Nah.
Not quite. You know what that means, don't you? You gotta go back. You got one too, Bobby?
Yeah.
Joe's is not 12, I don't think.
Wait a minute, we haven't measured him yet.
Yeah, I believe you're right, Bobby. I think that one's 12 inches. Let me look.
You mean nothing right before we measure.
Well, his just looked better than yours did. I guess that's why I did that. Lay him down flat. Lay him down flat. See the tail there. Slide it back a little bit now. We got to stay legal then. That's 11 inches long. You got to throw him back. So I know Joe's is not 12. I don't guess. I'll measure him just to see, Joe. I'm curious. No, you don't know. That's smaller than the rest of them. If they're 10 or longer, I'll take them. If they're 10 inches or longer, I'll take them.
After all the flags are gone, what's the next to go? Confederate graves. Join the Sons of Confederate Veterans. Help fight political correctness and keep Confederate flags flying. Join the Sons of Confederate Veterans. Fight back.
Indian Pass Campground, call today and come see the last of the real Florida. A neat, clean, quiet, and friendly atmosphere and a fantastic place to camp at Indian Pass Campground. Call today for reservations, 850-227-7203, 850-227-7203.
Wow, this snow sure is gritty and salty.
No, silly, this is sand, not snow.
So that's why it's so hot.
Yeah, but thank goodness our daddy owns A-plus air conditioning. He keeps our home as cold as Alaska.
Cool. Hey, I'll race you home.
For the most professional, most reliable, and most preferred air conditioning service in the area, call A-Plus Air Conditioning, 850-230-3009.
Okay, bet you I can win.
If you can dream it, we can do it. Sleek. Invigorating. Beautiful. Beauty at the Beach, where make-believe becomes reality. Back Beach Road, just west of Highway 79.
I think I got y'all beat with small ones, Joe.
I believe you have.
See? Can't even hold a hook in his mouth. Think you got a keeper, Bobby? Look like the way he's bowing that pole up. Let me get the net over here. Oh yeah, nice. That's a keeper. Come on in here. He gonna eat good tonight, ain't he, Joe? Yeah. Man. Well, congratulations, Bobby. Man, that's a good one. You ain't got to measure that one. Yeah, you tell him Joe Riley said everything's all right. Yeah, he's about 15 to 16 inches. He's got a skunk so far, Joe.
Yeah, I know.
But we got some good bites, so we know there's some more down there.
Good fish. Good eating. But if y'all have never eaten a ladyfish.
You call that a ladyfish?
That's a ladyfish. That's what I call a ladyfish. Technical name, the proper name is a sand perch. See the blue lines I was telling you about?
Yeah.
Sand perch, the turquoise line. They're bigger out in the Gulf.
That's what we used to call
a sand squirrel out in the Gulf.
A lot of different names, but the technical name is sand perch. It's just as wide as it can be.
So how come when I catch it, it's just an old squirrel fish? When you catch it, it's got a technical name,
right,
like a sand perch.
And they're good to eat.
Been drove all the way down here trying to catch one.
Well, you know,
I just wonder.
There it is. I told you I was going to catch one so you can see what I was talking about. So.
Okay, well, I'm going to let you eat him.
If you get a dozen, 15 of these, about that size, you got a good mess of fish.
Well, you would have if you get enough of them. Being that's a good, being you caught it.
A good grouper bait, too.
I'm going to cut this thing off till you catch something worth filming.
Okay.
He's off.
He's off?
That's what happens when you mess around, ain't it, Bobby? They get off. I'll leave you alone.
I don't know what it is, Bobby, but it's a good one.
It's always a good one, Ron catches it. It's going to be a good one.
Yes, sir, that's a good one. That's bigger than one you got.
That's as good a snake fish as I've ever seen.
Yeah, boy, I'll tell you what.
What kind of proper name have we got for him, Ron?
These are actually good to eat.
Oh, I'm sure they are. Yes.
It's a hybrid ling.
How about it, Bobby? What do you think?
It's a hybrid ling.
The hybrid ling.
Hybrid ling. Yeah, it's not a snake fish. It's a
hybrid ling. Okay.
Mine's a snake.
Well, mine's a
squirrel
fish, too, so.
Anyway, I'm sure I'm glad to know.
Full good, though.
All these years, and I didn't know these things.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Hybrid ling.
We got a record of him. That's
good.
They're
not legal, though. They're not legal.
Oh, okay.
Oh, speck, it's a white trout.
Sure is. Silver trout.
Silver trout.
That's nice.
He ain't gonna do it. He doesn't have any size or bag limit, does he?
I think he does.
Well, we'll take him to Hartford.
We're stopping by my house now.
We're gonna go to Hartford.
Oh, then go to Hartford. Then go to Hartford. Okay.
I got the first grouper of the day, Joe, on this grass flat over
there. Oh, yeah, I bet you have. Let's see him.
Black grouper. I don't think he's keeping. No, that's a black sea bass. I thought it was a little old black grouper. I'm going to measure him. 10 inches, I'm going to keep him.
Well, that sea bass became a grouper. That squirrel fish became a perch. You ever catch any sharks out here?
Well, actually, this is in the category with the shark.
Yeah, in the category. Yeah.
It's in the same category. It's just it's called a shark black sea bass. It's in some parts of the country. Here, they just call them black sea bass.
Hmm.
You got a good shot there,
dude. Oh, yeah, I got a real good shot. I blew him up.
Don't show me with it.
I blew him up about as big as I could.
King's Outdoors has been serving the hunters and fishermen in this area for many, many years. Come see them at their new location, now with a more extensive line.
At King's, we feature for the bass fisher the carrot stick rods, skeet reach rods, Garcia, Vengeance, and Vendetta rods, all with a replacement warranty. At King's, we feature the plastic baits that you want, from culprit to zoom. You'll find what you need in the hook line, from mullet snatch hooks to true turn for the pan fisher. The brim fisher, we feature year-round little jewel, red holland, and brim buster brim poles. At King's, we'll work hard to earn your business and keep your business. Come see. Yes.
When you're taking your vacation, make it all that it can be. Rest and relaxation for yourself and your family. When you take to the open road, you'll know what it's like to be free. If you want to find out how freedom feels, come to Holiday on Wheels. If you want to find out how freedom feels, Holiday on Wheels.
Have you got water problems? Pump won't pump. Do you need answers and solutions, but you don't want the runaround and you want someone honest? Well, have no fear, folks. Do what I did. Call the man, Water Dan. Dan Dubose will take care of your problem.
Hello, folks. This is Water Dan. I work on submersible pumps, jet pumps, do repairs and upgrades, anything to do with an existing water well. I would appreciate it if you call.
Call the man, Water Dan. He'll take care of your water problems. 850-535-9308. 535-9308.
Folks, you know why people from Washington, Jackson, Holmes, Bay County, you know why they call Water Dan? Because Dan Dubose knows what he's doing. Y'all give him a call.
pre-warn you if you didn't get what you want. I don't want you to throw me.
Nobody throwing things at us.
I'm going to throw Ron right over this counter.
I say it in love.
Initial by the departure
date.
I got all your info right here. Don't fill that out.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Are you
video?
Tell me you're
doing a damn thing.
Right there.
Are you paying attention, Ron? Ron, you ready? What's my tag number?
I'm smiling. I just don't know where you're pointing the camera.
Gonna tell her Flanny what I heard. A boyfriend said, don't start me talking. I'll tell her everything I know. I'm gonna break up this signal fight, cause somebody's got to go.